Right, welcome back to part two. This is a real struggle now. It's so much foliage and trying to show it all different has really proven to be a real pain. But we're persevering. We've got these, I was just putting these dark bits of leaves from that overhanging tree. There was a gorgeous cherry tree down here that I was scrumping like mad. I think I'll do some of those with a nylon mix brush to show some separate leaves. Right, we put some dark. This is all in shadow here, because of course the photograph overexposes it. Or underexposes, but I have got some nice little light leaves in here coming down from above. Through in here. Right, okay, let's lighten up this path a bit. A bit of ochre, a bit of sienna, a bit of blue. It's quite light in here. So it's one thing, putting the darks to make the lights. I'm just fiddling around with this, because that disappears into sort of infinity here. Well, that yellow, that light yellow, catching the highlights here, just. I'll put some dark behind there, dark green. Now there's some dark on the horizon, well on this bit here, just a shadow, just a reflection coming from that. Back bit there. I don't think my bluey, white blue sky reflection is really light enough. I will just put that back. Just. That wouldn't be much fun if it was all too easy, would it? I Let's get a little bit of light in here. Wind. There's quite a few fish in here. So I'm just opening it up a little bit. Right, we're just being a bit less distinct. There's no real no twigs or anything. There's some light catching bits of this. Now let's put my fingers in. Hopefully give a bit of scale to it. There's no sort of line there where all the shrubbery, there's a bank here. Get that bit of yellow or green here. Right, so. Needed a bit in here. I'll use my big brush for that. And I'll get a good clean, good dry. Flick it out. And try to just get these light greens, almost yellows. They're not really going to show. I'll do some rigger work in these. Dark green. Push the brushes or the bristles. Well, I think I better just do some of the rigour there. Really dark green. They're not quite as dark as I'm painting them, but I want them to register, so we've got all sorts of things here. Loads of damselflies. My brush clean. Let's get a little people brush. Now, as our friend Frank Clark says, carrots. Bit of dark, goldy. Mm. My wife was wearing shorts. It's hardly showing, is it? Small bit of shadow. Paint's drying very, very fast now. Hard these shows. Too close in time, so I'm going to do the figure darker. Just put the highlights on. Now, the legs, very faint flesh colour. Well, just about shows. Now if I put the shadow in, so that's about the best I'm going to do. Just carefully, just put that little highlight on the shoulder. And just on that side. Of the head catching the sunlight, and you have to look for this. Right, well that's the best I'm going to do. Then I'll need to put some pebbles on, so I'll get the pebble brush out. These are just bits of whitey ochre-y pebbles on the path. Little bits of detail in here, and same in here. Oh, we've got to put some poppies in, haven't I? To be really naff, as we say. Well, I'll tell you what they were there. They were sort of the plant flags. Bit of white, bit of blue. Yellow flags. Very subtle. Right, okay, I've almost come to the end of my tether. Good bit of vermilion. Just put in a couple of couple of poppies on the side of the path here. Warm this fog when that been in there. It's all a bit cold. Right, well that's the best I'm gonna do with this, I think. It's made my match here, I would say. I'll sign it. Always sign your work, good or bad. Because in my experience, well, you don't like, somebody else does. Right, I'll put this in the blue mount, because we've got a lot of blue in it. And have a look. No, there we go, maybe I'm too critical, but. Yeah, remember Frank Clark's directive, not the word. When you paint figures, horses, dogs, paint carrots, painted carrots. And then taper down to the feet. But there, my wife's legs were just a little bit in a walking position. Well, I don't know. What do you think? Let's zoom in. So there's my figure. That looks quite good from there. Now we'll come down to the foreground here. Just a tangle of reeds and nondescript stuff. And I've tried to give a recession, apart from the obvious perspective converging lines. I don't think I've quite pulled the reflections off. This might have been that better in watercolour, but I like all this. I like all this subtlety around here, just fading out, lost and found. But I must say, I did not find that the easiest painting I've done for a while. But I hope you enjoy it. This is part two. I'll say goodbye to you. Bye bye.